I got the moves. I got the moves. I'm making moves. You gotta move. You gotta make the city move. Like, whoa. I make the city move. I got the moves.
The Blazers just became the NBA's biggest disappointment after being swept by the Pelicans. They were once known as maybe the biggest surprise of the 2018 season, but now, they just flipped the switch and are the complete opposite. So where to go from here? What do the Blazers need to do to outplay their opponents? I'll be going over that in today's video. If you are new and enjoy the video, subscribe for more NBA content. But with that said, let's talk about the Portland Trailblazers. First, let's talk about the series. The Pelicans just shut down and dominated the Blazers in every way. Their defense, their offense, they simply just exposed the hell out of Portland. Massive credit to Jrue Holiday. He ruined Damian Lillard's life in this sweep, holding him to only 18.3 points, 4.3 assists, and 4.3 rebounds, and 32% from the field. And on offense, Holiday dominated Lillard, averaging 23.3 points and 6 assists on 53.4% from the field and having a 41-point game to close out the series. But we aren't talking about the Pelicans today. No matter how good they did, it's time to talk about the Blazers. And I talked about this in my last video, but Damian Lillard really let his team down this series. Those averages you saw earlier are not what you should see from an all-star. For reference, Lillard has averaged in this series 8.6 less points, 3.3 less assists, and shot 11% worse from the field than what he did in the regular season. So, with that said, does this mean that the Blazers should make any changes, any trades, or just blow things up? Let's take a look at some trade ideas. Many are saying trade CJ McCollum, as he has had a pretty poor season and played pretty badly in the playoffs. But to be honest, this doesn't seem that realistic. If Portland are trading CJ, who are they wanting back? Because it's most likely that they won't get anything great for McCollum, his value has really dropped recently, and if they want to win, he's the best option alongside Lillard. They have the chemistry, and they've performed greatly in the past, so if I were the Blazers, I'd pass on the CJ trade. Another crazy idea some people have touched on is trading Damian Lillard, and here's what I have to say to that. Do you want to contend? Because if you do, you'd want to keep Lillard. He's your best chance of continuing to compete. He did great in the regular season, and yes, he slumped in these playoffs, but that does not mean at all get rid of him. That's such an irrational move. Though it may look like the Blazers were crazily upset by a 6th seed, the reality is that they were swept by a team who won only one less game than them. Blowing the team up, making irrational trades right now, is not the way to go. All you are doing there is stuffing yourself over. You don't want to be rebuilding right now. The Blazers are still a highly competitive team and could go to the Western Conference Finals for all we know next season. People are overreacting way too much to this situation. It was a crazy loss. Not many people were expecting it to happen and for it to happen so fast. But I guarantee you Damian Lillard will come out balling next season and will take this team far again. The Blazers are fine. But of course, they'll still be wanting to upgrade their team. So who are some free agents they can sign? After looking at their roster, it's clear they may need an upgrade on the wing. In particular, the small forward position. They have a young Zach Collins, they have Alfarac Aminu, Harkless, but if they want to get out of the first round, then they may have to upgrade this position. Trevor Ariza or Doug McDermott could be good upgrades or better assets as key role players, but I don't think the players have much chance of signing anyone else. Maybe they could look for some upgrades on the bench or some defensive-minded players, but other than that, I don't think they could get anyone else. I don't think they could get LeBron, I'm sure they'd pursue him, but it's unlikely he'll join them. Let's take a look at the draft. The Portland Trailblazers are expected to fall around 24th, and with this pick, I think they should select Trayvon Duval, a 190-pound, 6'2 point guard out of Duke University. He'd be a good fit behind Lillard, but if they are able, the Blazers could also draft Zan Musa, a small forward from Bosnia, but I don't think he'd be available at their pick. But the biggest move the Blazers should make, if any at all, is fire their head coach, Terry Stotts. Though he has managed to get them a third seed, 10 straight playoff losses without a win is simply not good enough. It would be best to let him go, but if they can't find a potential upgrade, then maybe they should leave him. It's really a 50-50 decision. So overall, the Portland Trail Blazers should not blow things up. They should keep CJ and Lillard. It's best for the team and future of the organization. They should target small forward free agents and other players who can upgrade their bench and their defense. They should draft Trevon Duval and possibly even fire their head coach if it's the best thing they could do. The team is in an awkward situation and they need to find a way out of it, but blowing things up is not the answer. And that will conclude the video. What do you guys think? What is the Blazers' next move? let me know in the comments. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to drop a like and subscribe. But with that being said, I am out. Peace.